Hi world, this is the Fungible Millennial. I realised a while back I promised that I would do another suburb review if I got 20 likes for my Tasmanian suburb review video, and I have reached that. So this week I'm going to do a review for Lumia, which was a request on Facebook, and actually one of my guests on Moolah Moolah is doing some work in that suburb. I am super excited today to see what this suburb holds, so let's go. If you're new to my channel, I do videos on all things finance, from property to cryptocurrency investing. Before I start, I kindly ask you to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to my channel. And I'm not a financial advisor, and this video is just for entertainment purposes only. Lumia is named after an indigenous phrase for "here I rest." It is a suburb located 45 minutes drive or 40 kilometers southwest of Sydney city centre. It is a small suburb just northeast of the city of Campbelltown, which is near the outskirts of Sydney. It is located next to bushland and is accessible to some of the nicest national parks in New South Wales. On a 2016 census, the population recorded was 9,835, which is only up slightly from the 2011 census of 9,419 people. Lumia has its own station, and because of its close proximity to Campbelltown, it provides access to all the amenities there, including Campbelltown Hospital, Western Sydney University, the Campbelltown Golf Club, Campbelltown Mall, and some private as well as state-run schools. A quick look at the stats available on the Australian Bureau of Statistics website, we can see that the median age of people in Lumia in 2016 is relatively young, at 35 years of age. The main constituent of the population is older couples and families, which make up 21.9% of the overall population, whilst the next group down is established couples and families, followed closely by older independents. On Homely, the suburb is described as a great place for parks. It is clean and green, safe, and just a friendly neighbourhood with great public transport, but it isn't great for nightlife, fitness, childcare, or internet access. The demographic is mostly families with kids, professionals, single retirees, and the LGBTQIA+ community. According to CoreLogic, the median price is $661,000 for houses and is $416,000 for units. This data is based on 145 houses and 40 units sold in the month of June. The median rental is $390 and $330 for houses and units, respectively. The number of days the houses were on the market is relatively short, at only 24.4 days, whilst units were on the market for twice as long. No surprises, there was a high demand for property market in Lumia, with 1,148 visits per property, but this was below the state average of 1,670 visits per property. In the last year, there was a price growth of 7.92% for houses and 4.13% for units. This growth is relatively low compared to the state average of 20% and 9.61% for houses and units, respectively, in the state of New South Wales. In terms of vacancy rate, it is one of the lowest, with only 0.71%, and around 34% of the population is currently renting. Across the next 20 years, the state government envisions a potential 57,000 homes across 12 precincts, which includes Lumia and the neighbouring Campbelltown. The state government declares the area a growth area and expects to fulfil some of the higher housing demands in New South Wales. 65 hectares of land is being developed for new dwellings. After some pressure from the local opposition, the local government is planning to pour funds to improve infrastructure to keep up with the growth area demand. This news was only announced recently. However, there's no details of what types of infrastructure project the government is going to invest in. So, is this a good area to buy? Again, I stress that I'm not a financial advisor and I do this for entertainment purposes only. You really need to do your own due diligence before you purchase. The suburb has a lot to offer in terms of growth. as we see the median price of some of Sydney's more affluent suburbs, which are mostly located in the eastern side of Sydney, to be over $4 million. These suburbs include Tarramarra, Darling Point, Woolwich, Centennial Park, Bellevue Hill, Double Bay, Vaucluse, and Mosman. Although located less than 1 hour away from these affluent suburbs, Lumia is only a fraction of the price tag. Further out from Sydney is the gentrified western suburbs, including Annadale, Croydon Park, Dulwich Hill, Enmore, Lewisham, Lilyfield, Marrickville, and Newtown. These suburbs have a median house price of above $1 million. This is known as the middle ring suburbs of Sydney. Lumia is located in the outer ring suburb and is around 30 minutes drive from the middle ring. The suburb itself is relatively cheap compared to the skyrocketed price around the greater Sydney area. Hence, I think there's still potential and the risk is quite low compared to other suburbs in Sydney. Now, let's compare it with the neighbouring suburbs. First, the suburb of Campbelltown, where all the major infrastructure is located. This suburb has a median price of $682,000 for houses and $475,000 for units, which is on par with Lumia. The next suburb on the same side of the train track is Minto. The prices here have a slightly higher price tag, with a median price of $720,000 for houses and $487,000 for units. On the direct opposite side of the train track is the suburb of Woodbine. Here the houses have a median price tag of $685,000, but there's insufficient data for units. As you go further northeast and towards the city, the price seems to increase, which is no surprise. Currently, there are 34 properties on realestate.com, but on close inspection, 20 of these are under offer, with 14 for sale. Some of the homes listed are established homes with medium-sized land of above 500 meters square. There are a lot of new home and land packages added to the mix with land size of around 500 meters squared. I found another graph showing weekly asking price, which is inclusive of the current month of September. You can already see that the trend is getting out of the lagging phase of the S-curve. It is approaching what could be the start of the exponential growth. But of course, it's too early to tell if the exponential phase, as the data is incomplete. But it looks promising. Overall, I rate this suburb an investable suburb. I do like the fact that it's close to the main education facilities and shopping centres, as well as public transport. As long as the supply is still low and the demand is high, there is definitely capital growth potential to be had, as displayed by the price of the neighbouring suburbs. The recent announcement of infrastructure project into the local area is also a plus. This will definitely make the suburb more accessible, more in tune with the expected population growth, and create jobs. The only negative I see is that the rental yield is relatively low in the area. If you've seen my other videos, you know that the two main criteria for me to purchase a property is that it needs to have both good rental and capital growth. However, I know that people are putting money into installing granny flats at the back of existing homes in New South Wales to squeeze more rent from the land. And this is a great suburb to do so as the land is relatively large. Furthermore, in New South Wales, where the law on granny flats are not as tight as that of other states, this would just benefit you if you're willing to do the extra work. I hope you like this video on the review of Lumia in New South Wales. If this video hits 50 likes, I'll do another review. Make sure to sign up to my newsletter where I provide free and informative information on property, crypto, as well as share investing, as well as giveaways. Until next time, thanks for watching.